This is the solution to written homework 45. Okay, so let's think about this for a moment. So, find the volume of S. So, since it just says to the right of X is 9, just to the right of X is 9, that means that the answer is the integral from 9 to infinity. You have to go all the way to infinity because that's everything to the right of 9. And then pi a over x squared, so pi r squared h. Okay. So then, now, this is an improper integral. And the reason why it's improper is because that is that represents an unbounded shape. So we'll have to do the same truncate and limit. As usual, we'll go from, say, the integral from 9 to how about m of pi a over x squared dx, where m is more than 9, but constant. Okay, now that is something that we can do. So this would be, well, the pi can come out, so that's 9 to m, and then a squared over x squared dx. A is constant with respect to x, so it can come out. So that's pi a squared integral 9 to m. And then I'll write 1 over x squared as x to negative 2 dx. So now we can use the fundamental theorem. So this is pi times a squared, and then x to negative 1 divided by negative 1 evaluated from 9 to m. I'll spend this negative to reverse the order of evaluation. So pi a squared times 1 over x, and then evaluated from m to 9. So this will be pi a squared, and then 1 over 9 minus 1 over m. So that's the value of the truncated limit. So the truncated region. And to find the value of the full region, now we're going to let m go to infinity. So the limit as m goes to infinity of that thing, pi a squared 1 over 9 minus 1 over m. Well, m is the only, so that's the only m in all of this. Pi is a constant, a squared is a constant, 1 over 9 is a constant. 1 over m goes to 0 as m goes to infinity. So this is equal to pi a squared over 9. Okay, so this is the volume. Of S. The volume of S. Okay, so now for part B, the request is determine all values of A. That is to say, we want to solve pi A squared over 9 equal to 1, 3, 2, 6 pi. We want to solve that equation. Well, we can divide both sides by pi, multiply both sides by 9, and we obtain that a squared is 9 multiplied by 1, 3, 2, 6, so that a is plus or minus 3 times the square root of 1, 3, 2, 6. So 1326, does it have any squares in it? Let's see, 1326 divided by 4? No. Divided by 9? No. 16? No. 25? No. 36? No. 49, no. Okay, so then, what's the square root of 1326? 36. Okay, so then it has no squares. So those are the answers, the two possibilities, plus or minus 3 square root 1326. So for part C, here's the two possibilities. The possibility when A is 3 square root 1326. That is to say that we're going to be between y0 and y is 3 square root 1326 over x. The result looks like this. So, we're to the right of 9. So this would look like this, and we're taking this region. We're going to rotate it around the x-axis, so the result looks like this. So it's this whole volume. Okay, if we take that region and rotate it that way. But what this question is saying So this red right here is this one. But what the question is saying by there being two values of a is that we could have just as well done it this way. We could have said, okay. Or we could rotate. So that's 9. And we could have rotated this region around. Because this one right here is y is negative 3 square root 1326 over x. And in either case, you rotate this one around the x-axis and you get that. You rotate this one around the x-axis and you get that.